We're also following another developing story tonight in Fremont.
City Council unanimously votes to delay the illegal immigration ordinance.
This on the eve of a battle in federal court. KATV News Watch 7's Adrian Whitsett is live in Fremont. Adrian.
Brandy, tonight's vote means that the illegal immigration ordinance that was voted on June 21st by the City Council will not go into effect this Thursday. And those inside the packed City Council chambers inside of Fremont City Hall told the City Council exactly how they felt about the decision.
Fremont City Council didn't say much. In fact, they just pushed a button. All eyes, delaying Fremont's illegal immigration ordinance until court proceedings are done. Not everyone in attendance was in favor, citing a lack of trust in the council.
We know that you guys have been against this ordinance from day one.
I don't understand why we're delaying. That doesn't make sense to me. The Constitution says you had your chance, nothing personal. The public spoke. We want the ordinance.
While others still for the ordinance applaud the move.
We've waited 2 years, and if we have to go another 6 months to get it right, let's get it right.
Opponents of the ordinance in principle read testimonials for One Fremont, One Future.
3 days ago, while looking outside the window, I discovered that we were being fired at with BB guns. I'm not afraid for myself. I'm afraid for my children.
The City Council declines $300,000 in funding from a risk management agency and decided to hire Chris Kobach, who helped write the ordinance and is involved in similar legal battles across the country, as their pro bono attorney. Again, division amongst residents.
I think we put a lot of effort into this, and if Chris Kobach is saying we need to delay this, maybe we should delay it and get it done the right way.
If we bring Chris Kobach in for the next couple of years, I think that unity within the community will be difficult to maintain.
Coming full circle to John Wiegert, one of three who petitioned to get the ordinance on the ballot in the first place.
I'm a little disappointed they're suspending the ordinance, but from what I've talked to with my legal advisors, this is kind of standard procedure to kind of get them ready for the lawsuit.
Now, right after the vote, Amy Miller with Nebraska's ACLU released this statement to us. She says it was a responsible decision that will spare residents of Fremont from worrying about losing housing and jobs because of their appearance and accent pending a final resolution by the court. And that legal battle will take front and center stage tomorrow in front of a federal judge. The ACLU and a Mexican-American civil rights group have both filed temporary restraining orders against Fremont's ordinance, and so we'll just have to wait until tomorrow to see how much further this legal battle goes. In Fremont, Adrian Whitsett, KETV News Watch 7.